कभी कभी मेरे दिल में ख्याल आता है,
दो लाइन हो जाए सर।
वो तो
नो
दो लाइन हो भी गए ना।
सभी कभी
आपके बर्थडे पे टेस्ट मैच डेब्यू करना बहुत लोगों ने नहीं किया हुआ है।
प्लेयर रजिस्ट्रेशन फॉर द माइनर लीग क्रिकेट
एंड आई बैक इट बिकॉज देयर वाज अ पार्टनरशिप वाज सपोज्ड टू हैपन। सचिन वाज बैटिंग एट 67। आगुम्बेया
प्रेम संजया
Sanjay, you've forgotten we have defeated Australia in test match also.
What do you see the future of cricket here in America?
Got to be have three T's. Tactical, technical and temperament. Silsila ke koi bhi gana.
This song is dedicated to the legendary cricketer Sunil Joshi.
मैच बहुत ही रोमांचक लग रहा है और ये मारा यूएस की टीम से रोहन शर्मा ने सिक्सर एंड द वर्ल्ड कप इज आवर्स।
यस दिस विल बी पॉसिबल वन डे। यूएस में क्रिकेट का जोश इंडिया से कम नहीं। तो ट्यून इन टू आवर जोशीला ब्रांड न्यू क्रिकेट शो हैट्रिक विद संजय सक्सेना वेयर यू कैन गेट द रनडाउन ऑन एक्साइटिंग थिंग्स हैपनिंग इन द यूएस क्रिकेट वर्ल्ड। हियर फ्रॉम द क्रिकेट सेलिब्रिटीज फ्रॉम ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड एंड गेट टू नो द बडिंग प्लेयर्स एवरी संडे 1 PM पैसिफिक एंड 4 PM ईस्टर्न ऑन रेडियो जिंदगी।
वेलकम बैक टू हैट्रिक विद संजय सक्सेना और आज हम बात कर रहे हैं लेजेंडरी क्रिकेटर सुनील जोशी से। सुनील सर वेलकम बैक।
थैंक यू
सर। यू हैव बीन ए कोच फॉर जम्मू एंड कश्मीर, ओमान, हैदराबाद, आसाम, बांग्लादेश एंड यूएसए क्रिकेट टीम। वेयर एवर यू वेंट यू कंप्लीटली टर्न द टीम्स फॉर्च्यून्स। जम्मू एंड कश्मीर डिफीटेड मुंबई मुंबई, बांग्लादेश डिफीटेड वेस्ट इंडीज and they were very close to defeating India in a couple of matches. We were watching that very closely. What did you add or change in these systems, sir?
Sanjay, you've forgotten we have defeated Australia in test match also.
That's right.
And that was my first series as a spin consultant with them. I think it's all about making the players believe that what talent they have and always give them the extra support to them, whenever they need it. Mm-hmm. And also the belief that international cricket is all about being strong, being mentally strong. Skill to hai, unke paas to hota hai skill.
Right.
So to accept certain things, because better teams come and attack the smaller bowlers, the smaller teams. Mm-hmm. So we need to be prepared to when to withdraw ourselves and when we need to be smart in thinking about how batsmen can be outplayed.
Mm-hmm.
Mind communication is very simple. Mm-hmm. Understand the batsman before you bowl to him. Always have a plan A, plan B, plan C to the batsman. One of the plan will be successful. All three cannot be successful. At times, all three can be successful. So always be ahead over the batsman.
तो एक एग्जांपल थोड़ा देंगे, एक सिंपल एग्जांपल के बैट्समैन के क्या
सिंपल एग्जांपल है। इन क्रिकेट आई मीन माय कोचिंग फिलॉसफी हैज बीन वेरी सिंपल। टेक्निकली यू हैव एवरी थिंग विथ यू, यू आर साउंड, दैट्स द रीजन यू आर टेक्निकली बेस्ट इन द टीम। टैक्टिकली यू नीड टू बी वेरी स्मार्ट, यू नीड टू बी अ स्ट्रीट स्मार्ट क्रिकेटर।
Mm-hmm.
So for that, you need to really work. You need to be very, very sharp in your tactical areas.
Mm-hmm.
And temperamentally, you need to be very patient. You need to have a lot of patience, especially when you play the big teams, especially when you bowl to a bigger players. You need to have a lot of patience. So you've got to have three T's, tactical, technical, and temperamental. Mm-hmm. These are the three very, very important and value in cricketing career for any cricketer, whether it is an under 14 cricketer or a senior cricketer playing elite cricket. This is important. I mean, of course, the same things and same areas. When I was part of the US cricket team, I did work with so many spinners, and suddenly the spinners started performing and the fast bowlers started performing. The batsman scored runs. It's all about giving them the feedback. It's all about giving them the positive feedback. Even then, there will be a little errors. The moment you start talking about the positive feed and good things about their own players,
mm-hmm.
all these small errors will keep going. It's keep going down. They will forget that. They always think about the best part.
Right. So three things you talked about. Technical part is we all understand that, if you have to spin the ball, this is the technique to do that. So technical. Temperament is that you don't have to be angry, don't have to be driven by the situation there. But tactical, when you say, what exactly it means?
One tactical example. Is very important. You need to outclass the batsman. How many times you outclass the batsman? Why you want to get him out? Keep him quiet for 5 overs. Mm-hmm. Don't give him runs. Give him, if the batsman is comes from mindset of dominating you, or you want to hit only 4s and 6s, mm-hmm. give him one. Give him single. 3 overs, 3 singles, 4 overs, 5 singles, give him mm-hmm. singles. Then you see his reaction. How does he do? What does he do? Right? That is mm-hmm. one aspect. Generally, the top order batsmen, you know, they try and dominate when you see a slightly a lower percentage bowler. Mm-hmm. That, but the lower percentage bowler need to be driven very well, planned very well. Though you might come and attack, but I know where to withdraw myself.
Well, that's a wonderful thing. I hope our budding cricketers are listening to it, and then they know what to do, how to prepare for the big matches or even for their local matches.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, especially in T20 format, you need to be smart. It's all about smart cricket.
Right. And that's the future of the cricket, as we say, especially in US, because you cannot, for many, many years, you cannot have a test cricket. You cannot have, one day cricket definitely is happening. You have been the spin bowling coach also. So that brings me to the next question, sir, that you have been the US's spin bowling coach. As per your experience, coaching cricketers, seeing the atmosphere, infrastructure, and passion of cricket enthusiasts here in America, what do you see the future of cricket in here in America?
There is, there's no doubt about the passion is there. The players are there. Mm-hmm. I think in my view, I may be, because I didn't go across US and see how the infrastructure is built upon, mm-hmm. but wherever I've been to two places, that is, one is California, the Woodley Park. They mm-hmm. have a good big grounds, very fairly large grounds. And the other one is Florida. They have good ground as well, stadium. Those two grounds are there.
Yeah.
But for cricket to develop in US, you need to have a good infrastructure, facilities, grounds. You need to have the club cricket need to play on turf wickets. Lots of these young boys should start playing on a turf wickets. Then only the game will progress. Then you start building the pool of players across the country.
So infrastructure is the first thing. And then, but you have seen that there are so many teams, so much passion there. So you, and minor league has been announced. It's going to be starting next month. And then, as you know, major league is going to be starting soon, probably next year, if COVID situations are under control.
Fingers crossed, Sanjay, because jab bhi aap major league, minor league hote hai na, uske liye ground ki bahut zarurat padti hai, khas karke turf pitches ke. So, agar US mein ek saal mein itna stadiums ban sakta hai, itna pitches ban sakta hai, to fir nothing like it.
A lot of work is going on. You know, many, many turf pitches are being built as we speak.
That's a very challenging and daunting task for the US administrative officials to build overall the big stadiums, you know, big pitches. So then only you will attract the best of the players.
Right. So as we speak, a lot of turf pitches are being built, a lot of grounds are being built, you know, and looks like hopefully we have enough grounds so that we can conduct major league here. So we believe so.
No, definitely. I mean, if US can pull this off, there will be a lot of exposure and demand for T20 cricket.
That's right. You know, whenever there's an IPL or those T20 games, people here are awake whole night, or they wake up early in the morning to watch the games before they go to their work. So that thing, when then starts coming here in USA, then I'm sure it's going to be a big hit. Sir, you also have mentored U19 boys in NCAA Bangalore. How is your experience different coaching U19 as compared to the adults? And what are the tips that you want to give to U19 players?
I think it's very important, you know, when you work with a different size of the group, age groups, especially with the under 19 boys, since I work with them in the National Cricket Academy in Bangalore for quite some time. you really need to be get into their age group. So that's the best part. You know, as a coach, you get into closer to them, start talking about their own tone, their own interest, then they will be very, very opening to you. So you can't, I mean, it's again, we're being trained and our mind is trained to behave differently when you coach in a different atmosphere, different players, different background. Players come from different religions, different backgrounds, different castes, different culture.
Right.
So for us to get to together, the cricket is one thing which we got united. And for that, you need to be really, really focused. And that's where the players start loving it.
So we have to wear their shoes and then understand their feelings. And then on top of that, you have to build rather than authoritative lesson that do this, do that, right? So that's what I mean.
Classic example, Sanjay, if I can tell you, you sing like a Kishore Kumar. Can you sing?
No, I cannot.
You will sing like a Sanjay, not Kishore Kumar, isn't it?
Right. I will be Sanjay, yeah. That's why whenever I sing, I always wear a guitar and then I sing me on my own.
Yeah, see?
That's right. Aapki pasand ka gana bataiye.
As I said, Sanjay, earlier, one is, of course, Kabhi Kabhi. It's my favorite song. And otherwise, Silsila is, again, another movie which I really like, the movie, Amitabh movie. Silsila is, of course, every song is a beautiful song. So, and Silsila ke koi bhi gana aap bana do. I'm happy to listen to that and thankful to you.
दोस्तों आप सुन रहे हैं हैट्रिक विद संजय सक्सेना ऑन रेडियो जिंदगी और आज हम बातें कर रहे हैं लेजेंडरी क्रिकेटर सुनील जोशी सर से तो सुनते हैं उन्हीं का पसंद का ये गीत रोहित सैनी की आवाज में रोहित सैनी इज ए वर्सेटाइल सिंगर एंड ही इज नोन एज द किशोर कुमार ऑफ द बे एरिया तो सुनते हैं ये रंग बिरंगा गाना होने की आवाज में
रंग बरसे अरे रंग बरसे भीगे चुनर वाली रंग बरसे भीगे चुनर वाली रंग बरसे भीगे चुनर वाली रंग बरसे हाँ रंग बरसे भीगे चुनर वाली रंग बरसे हो रंग बरसे भीगे चुनर वाली रंग बरसे यार बलम तरसे रंग बरसे हो रंग बरसे भीगे चुनर वाली रंग बरसे हो रंग बरसे भीगे चुनर वाली रंग बरसे का चक दम दम चक दम दम चक दम दम चक सो गुरी का यार बलम तरसे रंग बरसे ओ रंग बरसे भीगे चुनर वाली 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 रंग बरसे बरसे भीगे चुनर वाली रंग बरसे ओ रंग बरसे भीगे चुनर वाली रंग बरसे ओ रंग बरसे भीगे चुनर वाली रंग बरसे ओ रंग बरसे भीगे चुनर वाली
क्रिकेट लवर्स दिस सॉन्ग इज डेडिकेटेड टू द लेजेंडरी क्रिकेटर सुनील जोशी.
वेलकम बैक टू हैट्रिक विद संजय सक्सेना और आज हम बात कर रहे हैं लेजेंडरी क्रिकेटर सुनील जोशी से. सुनील सर, योर सन आर्यन जोशी, इज ही इनटू क्रिकेट? व्हाट इज ही डूइंग?
यस, ऑफ कोर्स आर्यन इज इन ग्रेड 12 एंड ऑफ कोर्स ही डिड प्ले क्रिकेट एंड ऑफ कोर्स ही इज कम आउट विद द रैंक्स फ्रॉम अंडर 14 टू 16 टू द 19. Mm-hmm. And he is enjoying at this point of time, since the circumstances in India is not that keen to go out and go to the academies because of the lots of restrictions. But he does a lot of skill practice along with me in the last 4-5 months. So he does his fitness, he does his bowling, he does do some skill sets, and he does some training. That's good.
That's good. So lockdown is helping with developing the skills at home.
Probably, I think both of us spending more time. Since I was traveling a lot before this lockdown happened, and of course now I'm pretty free and happy to give him time and wherever he needs it.
More bonding. Sunil sir, Aryan Joshi is also doing some work on the mental strength of the cricketers. Do you want to throw some light on that? What is he doing?
See, basically, Aryan is doing this is a community initiative called Importance of Mental Strength for Youth in Sports.
Okay, so overall sports, not just cricket.
Yeah. So basically, this initiative is a non-profit, non-commercial initiative. Mm-hmm. And this has started from Aryan, I've been in the back seat of this. He's a driver. I'm just a passenger in the train of this initiative. Mm-hmm. The idea of him came to me in one of the breakfast days, and he asked me about this is what I want to do. I said, feel free to do. I mean, you explore your things. I said, no, Papa, I want to do this initiative because this subject has been not many people, or especially in sports, nobody has addressed this part or driven this initiative to reach out to the required players or eligible players, if you consider that part. Otherwise, also in life, mental strength is very important. And that too for a player, in any sport you take it, be it cricket, be it hockey, any across India, we have so many sports.
Mm-hmm, right.
In that way, he is trying to reach out to the players, talk to the players, understand that what challenges they gone through and how did mental strength help them to overcome that challenge. Mm-hmm. And what are the ways of acquiring your mental strength stuff, what were the objectives and how did mental strength help them to achieve the success. Mm-hmm. So that has been really remarkable. I think it's there on the Insta and Facebook. He's already there. I think probably he's finished season 1, season 2. I think season 3 is just started. Mm-hmm. He has done nearly spoken about 100 plus athletes in across India. Mm-hmm. From men to women to para-athletes to the everyone. So that initiative has really done well. And I'm sure that it will continue to do well because we thrive for the success and we thrive for initiative to reach out to the across India.
Wow, so that's a wonderful thing, because that part is really missing in any sports, mental aspect. I mean, there are some coaches, they cover the mental aspect, but it's not very like common to talk about mental aspect of the game, especially after the social media. I mean, those days jab aapke aur hamare time the tab to phone nahi tha, so we were like limited to information that we just needed. But right now, because the social...
It's very important, Sanjay, especially, some athlete, you know, today's time at the age of 12 or a 10, if he has been addressed why and how mental strength can be developed, he'll become a better sports person. He will understand all the challenges. He will do the right things so that it will help him. So RN is only 17. If a 17-year-old kid can go out and does this initiative, so it's a really a remarkable. I mean, because RN, I'm not saying because he's my son, because anyone does these sort of an initiative, it'll always be very helpful to across the sporting fraternity of India, everywhere.
Oh, in the world, yeah, that's right.
In the world, right? So yeah. that's very important for us to understand the requirement, and this initiative should spread the awareness of how mental strength will help to become a better player, better citizen.
Mm-hmm. That's great. That's a wonderful, amazing work by him. It's not just for the sports, but for anybody. Like we saw the case of Sushant Sri Rajput. He couldn't handle that. And, you know, a lot of players also, they...
This initiative is not restricted to only sport. It is open to everyone. So everyone needs in life, generic also, you need mental strength, right? From the age 10 to age 70, everyone has a different mental challenges to counter it, to challenge it.
That's right. So hats off to your son then, Aryan. Aryan, thank you so much for doing this work, and we'll find what you're doing and we'll spread it in our country. Sunil sir, let's talk about your IPL experience. So the games are totally different. A lot of crowd, a lot of noise, a lot of people, you know, a lot of fun, a lot of loud music, especially that, you know, when you go there. A lot of things there. How is it different from the other T20 matches that you play for the nation?
I think IPL is a pure entertainment. People come there to have a good time with his friends and families. At the same time, they enjoy the game because the game finishes in 3 hours. So they can have a meal, they can have a quick fun time with the family, friends, and within 3 hours, they are back home. The game is finished. At the same time, the players had a lot of responsibilities. It is a high intensity game for a player. Because जो भी आप वनडे में क्रिकेट खेलते थे 50 ओवर 100 ओवर में यहाँ पे आप 40 ओवर में सब कुछ डालते हैं because of the intensity level, because of the game demands that much. It's a speed game, you know, by the time you realize your 20 overs is over, right? So you need to be on the button every ball while batting, while bowling, while fielding. So that's the best part of it.
So, आपने रॉयल चैलेंजर्स के लिए यू प्लेड फॉर 2 years.
I didn't play for रॉयल चैलेंजर्स for the first 3 years. It was fun. It was good fun because we had a good team as well. Because Rahul was there, Anil Kumble was there. Of course, Virat Kohli was also part of the team. Dale Steyn was there.
Right.
Zahir Khan was there. It was a good team. Of course, you know, later on, then Chris Gayle and AB de Villiers came. So, hopefully, you know, they can get the cup this year.
We all are waiting for that.
Yeah, absolutely.
Sir, the last question for the day about your wife, Dr. Ravneet, is a pediatrician. So what's your story? You know, how did you meet her? You know, how do you, aapki love story kya hai?
A love story to love story rehne dijiye. I mean, of course, I've been blessed to have Ravneet in our life, and she's been a wonderful person, friend, and a philosopher and a guide across throughout my playing career. And she's a pediatrician and she's a lactation consultant who works with Manipal Hospital in Bangalore. Mm-hmm. And she's been the force driven by from her side for Aryan and me to go and achieve our goals, so that she has taken her profession as a backseat and allowed me to take my profession and supported Aryan in every step of the life. So we are very proud of my wife.
That's a great to know. Behind a successful man, there is always a woman. So again, there is an example, classic example of that. Sunil sir, thank you very much for your wonderful time that you given to us. But before we go, हमारे दर्शकों को जो देख रहे हैं और हमारे listeners को जो हमें radio पे सुन रहे हैं, उनके लिए आपके पसंद का एक गाना.
I'm very thankful to you, Sanjay, for having me invited for this show. And I just want to tell all the viewers, you know, the viewers and your followers and the sports followers, not cricket followers, sports followers,
yeah,
and the budding young cricketers, you just need to follow your passion, chase your passion, don't leave it, achieve it, go get it. These are my words, you know. And along with all these 4-5 lines what I've used, there is a lot of sacrifice from your side. There is a lot of efforts from your side. There is a lot of stress from your side. But those efforts, sacrifice, stress, it is enjoyable. So enjoy it while doing it.
It's, I hope हमारे cricketers, budding cricketers और जो भी cricketers हैं, budding के अलावा जो established हैं, वो भी they all listen to it and learn from it. Thank you so much, Sunil sir. We really are honored to have you on our show and wish you all the best with your new role. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you. Bye.